Good day, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to another episode of Justice Talk, where it's justice talking. Today, I am joined by Sergeant Jeff Miller. How you doing, Jeff?
Good. How's everybody today?
Well, having good. A great time. And also by Deputy Brian McKnight. How you doing, Brian?
Doing good, man. Nice day out there.
It's a terrible day out there.
It's a little cold.
It's a little cold, a little snowy. It's in my head, it's another, what was it, Snowpocalypse, Snowmageddon? Bomb cyclone. It feels like it to me, but
No bomb cyclones this week.
No bomb cyclones. It's just a little bit of snow, and a lot of interesting weather coming for this Halloween. It looks like, huh?
Yeah, gonna have to dress warm on this one.
So, what do you want to talk about today?
Well, let's talk about some Halloween stuff.
Let's just makes sense.
We can talk about our experiences with Halloween and.
All right. So,
ways to keep yourself and your kids safe for Halloween.
I think that just makes sense. I think that's a good topic. Brian, what was your Halloween like as a kid?
Man, I tell you, I remember the Halloweens where sometimes it wouldn't snow and it'd be warm and you'd be out there and wouldn't have to wear even a jacket. And then you'd have years like we have today where you're going to have to dress real warm. And you got these little costumes out of a box and it had a plastic mask and it had this just paper type thing that covered your jacket, and you always got mad because you couldn't tell what you were because your coat was covering your costume, and you'd go out there and people would go,
"What are you?"
Yeah,
you have to open your coat.
See, I grew up a little different. I grew up in Arizona, so it was just a free for all on whatever you wanted to wear. Most of the time, it was. I'm going to go out as a scuba diver, so I could just wear a pair of shorts and a mask and. Call it a day.
Wow. I'm glad I missed that.
Yeah, I'm glad you missed it too, now that I say it. So, back then it felt a little different. I know everybody had their favorite locations to go trick-or-treating. I personally, in my hometown, there was the golf course community because they were was kind of affiliated with money, so you might get the good candy.
You got the big candy bars.
You need to get the full-size Snickers or the... The Reese's, those are my things.
That's right.
Well, and you knew where to go, and even back then, 30 years ago, you still had to be wary of where you went.
Sure.
You wanted to go to places that your family knew.
Oh, yeah, and before you left, Mom was asking you all those questions. Where are you going? Who are you going with? Yep. How long are you going to be gone? All those questions, and you'd think as a kid, man, come on, Mom, really? But now we really understand why she'd ask all those questions.
It's weird when you become a parent and it turns around and you're like, wait, slow down.
Oh, yeah. You do all the same stuff.
Yeah, my kids are still young, so we actually go trick-or-treating with them. That's what we do now. But I remember as a kid, I was, same age as my daughter. She's 8. And my parents, because we lived on a cul-de-sac, would just kind of set me loose. She knew where we were and what we were doing. She knew all the neighbors. We kind of had that trust there. But then it wasn't soon after that I personally started trying to, stretch out my reach.
Yeah.
So I would gradually start leaving the cul-de-sac where I wasn't telling them where I was going. Turns out that's not a good idea. You get in a lot of trouble.
No, you got to be careful now. And it's great when you open the door and you see the kids at the step and the parents are right down the sidewalk there, staying with them, hanging out, making it safe.
Absolutely. One of the things I really love these days is just the whole trunk or treat system that's starting, where people will set up in a parking lot or a very safe, enclosed, controlled environment inside a gym, whatever it might look like, and then just have a bunch of vendor booths or the back of people's vehicles just open with a bunch of candy ready to pass it out with their parents right there. Yeah. And then it kind of takes out the vehicle element.
And there was a bunch of those this weekend, and I'm not sure how many are going to be going on the night of Halloween, but those are definitely a good event, and everything's right there, and you're not traveling super far to get door to door.
Sure. And I kind of like that part. I don't have to go walking for 15 miles with my kids because, yes, they're 6 and 8, but, man, they're willing to put the distance and the miles on when it comes to – getting the candy, filling those bags.
Oh, you know it. And they're reaching in the bag and eating their candy as they're going to the next door if you let them.
If you let them.
That's one thing you need to do is remind your kids not to eat that candy until they get home.
It's important to inspect it because, mm-hmm. I mean, first off, you're the parent and you get first dibs at the best. That isn't that kind of way. It does work that way. That's, you're, quote, inspecting for no poisonous things. But furthermore, just to make sure that there isn't anything shady being put into their bag.
That's right.
So what else do you think? Anything that kids can do? I mean, there's a lot of safety things we can think about for kids when they're out walking the streets at night, especially when the light comes down. Because I know in my neighborhood, most of the trick-or-treating is happening during daylight hours, right? When the sun drops is the exact same time that kind of all the kids come in, because it's a lot of smaller kids. But that's not every neighborhood by any means.
And it's getting dark quick, and some of these costumes are really dark and hard to see. Carry that flashlight and have something on that costume that makes you stand out so anybody in a vehicle driving by can see you and make it a safe event.
Absolutely. So some of the tips that we've read are saying decorate the either bags, costumes with reflective tape, stickers, lights, anything like that. Choosing light colors. A lot of the costumes that people are getting are very dark, very black, and you see basically a shadow on the side of the road suddenly jet across the road. That's scary
one thing you need to worry about when you're driving. Is you need to, on Halloween, you got to figure that somebody's going to run out in front of you when you're driving through your neighborhood. So
sure,
just be prepared for it.
Absolutely. One of the other things they're saying is to, instead of masks, try to use face paint or something like that so that it doesn't obstruct the kids' vision.
Right.
Or your vision, because the hope is that you have a good general awareness of where you are and what you're doing.
Well, and that's where you got those little ones and the parents are really keeping track of the kids and trying to keep them together because they will be distracted.
Sure. Very good. And then, so when we talk about vehicle safety, when you're driving at night, I mean, big tip is going to be slow down.
Definitely.
Like for anybody driving on the road that night. And even if you're on a major roadway and you're not thinking that any kids are going to be crossing, this is a night where people are going to be anywhere and everywhere.
Right, yep. Right. And they're excited to get to the next house. So
they're real excited.
And with the way the weather's looking, you're going to need to drive slow anyway.
Right. Right. Well,
this snow and ice coming.
So and that probably talks about being very careful with the exposure. Sometimes people think Halloween is an opportunity to dress a little more provocatively when they get to be a teenager. Kosha just gave me a funny look when I said that, but it's true. And just remember that teenagers, anything like that, especially when it's going to be real cold outside, probably a very good idea to layer, layers.
Because you know those little kids, they'll just keep going door to door until they're frozen, but they want more candy, so keep an eye on them.
And they are amped up and sugared up and
yes,
ready to go.
Yes, they are. That's right.
Well, Kosha asks an interesting question here. Is how old is too old to trick or treat? I think she secretly wants to go still.
I was 92. I mean, at what point can't I walk anymore? No. I think it is going to be a parent's discretion on that, because it is kind of strange when you're that one parent that is opening a door to a 17-year-old kid with a trick or treat,
right.
And you're like, huh?
He's barely in a costume.
Right.
It's just, I'm here for the candy.
Wears a pair of jeans and puts a little like blood streak from his lip. And
right.
Like, huh?
Yeah, that does make it weird.
You get one dum-dum, pal.
That's right.
I used to love dum-dums, though. Those were a win in my basket.
Only certain flavors.
Right, that's true. What age is appropriate? I mean, it is going to be discretion. I would assume that most people have the understanding that trick-or-treating is probably generally over by the time you're getting into the high school ages, you think?
My kind of thoughts on it is about the time you get to middle school, that's probably about the time that you probably need to start doing something else.
Right. And we're not condoning going out and doing Halloween parties or anything like that. We're just saying that, you know, there might be the other things that you can do on that night, like hand out the candy, like help your parents.
Right.
Weird. What's Kosha? Kosha's coming with another question saying, what's the funniest trick you have been asked to do? I've never been asked to do a trick.
I haven't either.
I've had that trick or treat, and they say go for a trick, and then you kind of get stunned because you're not thinking, I want the candy.
Right. I'm not really willing to do a trick.
I
have played tricks on people after not getting candy. But that's not something
that's not
I'm willing to really
show.
Talk about.
No, don't talk about that here.
I did one time we raised some pumpkins in the backyard, and this thing was huge. And I was able to cut the insides out, stick it on my head, and put a big black cape on me. And I would sit there at the porch as the kids come up and then say hi to them. Try, you know, I'd see the little ones and try to be nice about it. But it was kind of fun because it was just a pumpkin on a big black cape. And then I'd start talking to everybody. So that was kind of a fun trick to them as they That's came great. Up to the porch.
Coach is full of fun questions today. All right. Now she's coming in saying, what is the worst treat you were given?
A toothbrush.
I think so.
I remember the getting toothbrush.
Again, you're dental there for floss. The candy, and people are saying, hey, instead, why don't you worry about your dental hygiene? That's not what we're worried about tonight. That's tomorrow for my parents to worry about.
Mental note for next year. Skip the house.
Skip the house with the toothbrush.
But you always knew. I mean, you knew the people that gave out full-size candy bars. And, you know, I had a guy in my neighborhood that worked for a soft drink distributor, and he'd had out full cans of 12-ounce cans of soda every year. So
should have come to your neighborhood.
Yeah, so he'd always go change costumes two or three times and go back. You'd hit those houses
again. That was Jeff's trick right there, changing costumes.
Get the big scores multiple times.
Yeah, so you'd note which houses were giving out good stuff and go back.
That's funny. Oh, man. So I have so many fond memories of you know, just coming through this whole season and going through Halloween. Some people go all out with what they do and how they do it. I know I've got some neighbors that are just they're all about the full on decor, the jumping spiders that come out at you. My wife is trying to get me to put up Christmas lights already.
We got a Halloween stuff everywhere in our house. Good. Definitely.
Yeah, we got a house in my neighborhood that always sets up a haunted house in the garage, and it's just grown over years, and people almost expect it every year now.
See, that's a bummer when it comes to it being expected.
I think they've done it. There's a couple of years where they skipped it, and people are like, what's going on?
Do you like haunted houses, though? I hate them.
They're not my favorite.
I hate them.
I ain't going.
I remember as a teenager getting kicked out of one because I hit some guy because he jumped out at me and I just kind of reacted.
Have you ever been in one?
Like actually as an actor? No.
No, I got to be a zombie in one time and come out of a grave. So
that was pretty
It was actually a haunted house that was put on by a fire department.
How did we get video of that happening? I mean, I really want to see that.
Okay, so out of all those years, what was the best costume you ever wore or saw?
For me, it's the first year I met who's now my wife. We did a Halloween party, and I went as a blue man in the blue man group. And I just basically put on a blue Speedo cap, like a swimming cap.
Okay.
And painted my face blue, my arms blue, my hands blue, and I left a trail of blue everywhere I went for the entire night. That was my favorite costume just because everybody knew where I was because there was blue.
Well, and back when we were kids, like I said, you go to the store and it came in a box and it was a plastic mask and there wasn't a lot of creativity. And I remember me and my buddy had this old bed sheet and it was green. So we thought we'd get all creative and we put together this paper mache dinosaur head, and we put the boxes together, and we were a two-legged dinosaur, and we'd go to school, and they'd have that little parade, and we couldn't see where we were going, but we thought it was the coolest costume ever because we got a little creative with it. And I always remember that one.
I don't know that I've had a favorite costume, but, man, if I had a nickel for every time that I was working and wearing a uniform that people would comment on your costume. So
best costume of the year. Most realistic.
And I remember working those Halloweens where I'd make sure I'd keep candy in the car. And any kid I could get close to, and it would be good candy. We'd get the good stuff.
Nice.
Make sure they got some good stuff.
Last year, I actually made a point to, since I was working, I actually drove around the neighborhood with my lights flashing. Not to do anything, but just to increase everyone's awareness and kind of like pay attention to where you're at and remind people to slow down a little.
Oh, definitely.
Kosha, I'm making you come get on the mic real quick so you can tell us your favorite costume. I'm assuming it's Star Wars related.
Have you ever
been dressed as... No,
my favorite would probably be Mike. Get on the mic. Get in here.
Yeah, get on the mic.
Come around.
No, My favorite would probably be my son, Seth. He wanted to be creative, and he always thought it was really cool to dress differently. So when he was, I think, a sixth or seventh grader, I made him a box, and he went as a cat in a litter box, and it was awesome. I mean, he had cat kitty litter, and then the little, I think it was Tootsie Rolls, and then the upper part of him was like a cat, and everyone just thought that was the greatest thing. So I don't think I ever had any great ones, but also now that thinking about that, one of the parents that came by trick-or-treating one year, she had the best one. She was dressed up as a big box of wine, and she was actually giving all the parents wines from her box of wine. So that was awesome.
Very nice.
Definitely creative there.
Yeah.
I like seeing the creative ones, like especially the ones now where it looks like the person walking is them actually riding a horse or something like that. So it looks like a little horse underneath a big guy. And they're
right,
like,
right.
I love those.
Yeah, they're amazing type of things going out there now.
Yeah. So, yeah, anything else we want to address today? I mean, generally speaking, I think it's going to be real important to just remember for everyone, from parent to driver to child all the way down, just remember to be safe, including the person handing out the candy. Make sure you're taking that on safely also.
Yeah, that's right. And if you don't have parents with you, you're a little bit older group, stay together. Don't go out there, one or two of you, where it's hard to see you. Stay in groups. Make sure you're safe and you know what the route's going to be and you know what to do in an emergency. Do you have a cell phone so you can call if you do need help?
And yeah, at least one or two people in your group should have flashlights. And
yes.
Yeah, wear the reflective stuff, have the lights available, glow sticks, whatever you got to do to make sure that people can see you. It's not going to mess up your costume. If anything, you can actually use those glow sticks to maybe amplify the costume. You can make, you know, glowing teeth or whatever you got to do to make it so you're actually visible out there.
Make sure that you use sidewalks or paths rather than walking down the middle of the street. That's
always hard when you're driving down those busy neighborhoods at night and there's just 100 kids in front of you and you're just trying to get to your destination. Yeah.
And if you're not comfortable with any situation, no, you need to get out. Have a plan with all your friends. Just make sure you're uncomfortable. You go to a door and things don't seem right. Get out of there.
Oh, Coach is itching again.
She's coming in.
Sorry, I have one more safety thing. Okay, so if you go to a house and there's no one there, but they've left the bowl of candy out there, say to take one piece, don't take the whole bowl. That's just rude.
That's right.
I like it. Yeah. I like it.
But who just puts a bowl of candy out on the porch?
We do.
You do that at your house.
Okay. I do that at my house too because we're out trick-or-treating. So when we're out trick-or-treating, we'll leave a bowl out during that time. Trying to still provide some candy, but
Right. Yeah,
it always comes back empty because you know there's one or two bigger kids that help themselves. But
I remember when my kids were little and my wife would take the kids out, trick-or-treat, and I'd stay behind at home to hand out candy, and I'd just turn off the lights.
old funny.
More candy for me.
I like it.
You always buy the stuff you want. So.
Right.
Okay, and then let's see, drivers, be safe, slow down, keep just really great situational awareness that night. Make sure you're always paying attention while you're driving. If you're handing out candy, just make sure when you do close it up that you're actually locking your doors, windows, blinds, all that good stuff. You don't necessarily want people coming in and trying doors or trying to play tricks on you.
That's right.
Exactly.
Who else? Did we cover everybody?
I think we're looking good. It's a big day. Everybody have fun out there. Dress warm and have some fun.
Are you dressing up this year?
You know, I got grandbabies.
I know you do. What are you going to be, Brian? Come on.
That I haven't figured out yet.
I'm going to be Superman. I have a giant Superman onesie, and that's what we're going to be rocking this year.
You got to take pictures on that one.
No.
All right.
And how about you?
I have no idea. I haven't planned that far yet.
All right. Fair enough.
Depends on the weather.
Depends on the weather.
Right.
So, yeah, that's what I'm doing the onesies, guys. I can layer like 15 layers underneath the onesie and I still look all right.
That's a good plan.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, I mean, just again, be safe out there. We wish you a very happy Halloween and hopefully have a great time out there. Please make sure to follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and now here on the different podcast venues.
All right. So, until next time.
Have a great one.